afternoon, everyone. Paul's going to be running a few minutes late from what I have just heard. So we'll be starting off an acapella in a couple of minutes after they do the messages before Mass starts. Okay? Thank you.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the Church of the Holy Spirit and the Eucharistic celebration of the sixth Sunday of Easter. And also, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. Wednesday devotions will be at Holy Spirit during the month of May. Please come together with your community to enjoy this special afternoon with song and prayer. On Thursday, May 13th, we will celebrate the Ascension of the Lord. The Mass schedule is as follows. 8:30 a.m. here at Holy Spirit, 12:10 p.m. at Holy Trinity, and 5:30 here at Holy Spirit. Christ died to bring us life in the Spirit. Let us give thanks and praise to God. Our celebrant today is Father Matt Wetzel.
Once again, good afternoon. We're going to start off today, and if you remember the words to this, I know you don't have the books, but Christ the Lord is risen today. Please stand. Christ the Lord is risen today.
Mother's Day weekend. At this time, we gather our thoughts, we trust that God is with us, and that He so generously shares with us His love and compassion. Lord Jesus, You raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You feed us with Your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Together, let us praise God's holy name with a Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise You, we bless You, we adore You, we glorify You. We give You thanks for Your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, be glorious in the world, Lord, the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of God. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to you in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and, falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, the word of the Lord. Our responsorial psalm, "The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power." The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song. Sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. He sent his only Son to the world, so that we might have life through him. And this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he has loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. come to him. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away, and I will come back to you. If you love me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay, time for a confession. So, anyway, you know how we are in year B for the readings? Yeah, I just realized I just read the gospel for year C. Oopsies. Well, here's a good thing. Now, the good thing is that, thankfully, the reading is not that far off from what I should have been reading. The reading for year B for Sixth Sunday of Easter is John 15, chapter 15, 9 through 17. Whereas I just erroneously read John chapter 14, verses 23 to 29. So, for anyone keeping score, watching at home, sorry. Anyway, moving right along. Okay, so one of the key themes for this weekend is how Jesus reminds us of how much love God has for us. And he says this, "I have told you this so that my joy may be in you, and your joy might be complete. No one has a greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends." And I was thinking about this earlier today, thinking, you know, I do think this is somewhat providential. I really do. Because not only is this weekend the sixth Sunday of Easter, where Jesus is preparing his disciples for when he will return to heaven on Ascension Thursday, so not only is it in preparation for that, but this weekend is also Mother's Day weekend, and we can think of the intimate love that the Father and the Son share, and it really does come across like a parent to a child. And consider how Jesus very freely refers to his Father as Abba, meaning Daddy. Likewise, think of the intimate relationship between mother and child. One way we can consider this relationship, or one illustration, is the love that the Blessed Mother has for her child, Jesus. You can think of Mary, think of her being told that she would become the mother of our Lord Jesus in Nazareth, and her fiat, her yes to God, how much that changed salvation history. We can think of her raising her son and loving him so much. We can think of how she was really responsible for the beginning of his public ministry, the first recorded miracle, when she instructed him to provide more wine at the wedding at Cana, and how she, of course, was there during his darkest moments, and how she held his body after he had been taken down from the cross. But then, of course, we also do trust that she was assumed body and soul into heaven, and we will celebrate that day on the Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary on August 15th. And so we can see the tender, loving care that Mary showed her son, and likewise the tender care that Jesus shows to her. Consider also from John's Gospel, while Jesus is on the cross, he looks at his mother with love, and how he tells the beloved disciple, "Son, behold your mother," and to her says, "Mother, behold your son." And he is giving Mary to him for a lot of reasons. One being the practical reason. Jesus wants Mary to be well taken care of. He doesn't want her to be at risk for not having basic necessities, shelter, home, you know, things of that nature, food, someone to watch out for her. But we can also consider too how Jesus, in a way, reminds us that she is also our mother, one who watches out for us, the one who advocates for us, who prays for us, who intercedes for us. And thankfully, there are so many mothers who throughout the course of the years, so many mothers have been such wonderful instruments of co-creation, bringing new life into the world, loving their children deeply, and teaching them and nourishing them. I am very grateful from my own perspective for all that my mother has done and continues to do for me, my sister, my dad, and how she takes such good care of us, and how she, especially while growing up, she was so instrumental in being there for us. Especially as a stay-at-home mother, I am very grateful for all that she did and very grateful for all she continues to do for me at this point in my life as well. Likewise, sometimes though, there are times when we do have to pray for forgiveness for the times when mothers have been unfortunately, when they've dealt with certain demons, you might say, dealt with certain addictions, have dealt with their own troubles, and in some cases, we know of situations where mothers were not at their best, and they in those situations struggle with prayer and healing, because those scars can run deep, they really can. And in some ways, we celebrate Mother's Day weekend, we give thanks to Almighty God for giving us the Blessed Virgin Mary as our mother as well. And likewise, we thank him for the gift of all the mothers who have come throughout the years, and those mothers who are still to bring children to the world, or be mother figures, maybe not literal mothers, but mother figures. And they're so important. In so many ways, they truly are inspired by the example that the Blessed Mother gives them. Together, let us now stand as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. Christ's sake, he was crucified in Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in the world to judge the living and dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess with baptism the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus said, "Whatever you ask the Father in my name will be granted. Therefore, let us place our needs before God."
That those searching for faith in a chaotic world encounter Christ in every member of the church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers everywhere, may they recognize the gift of their children and nurture them with joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may learn to honor diversity in culture, ethnicity, language, and life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who gather here see the face of Jesus and one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those requests that have been included in our Book of Intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in need among us, especially the sick, the dying, and those who have died, we especially pray for Louis DiGiacomo, Mary and Herman Carbonelli, Mary Priolo, Tammy Iacobucci, and David Esper. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Triune God, we feel your presence in our lives. Draw us closer to you through the power of the Spirit, and grant our prayers in the name of Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
sinners, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord's sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offering, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed by the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord, brought us from above all, to love to yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For where the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember the Lord your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you. Your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into thy roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of the saving food. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At this time, I would like to invite just the ladies to remain standing, those who are able to stand, the gentlemen, if you can be seated for a moment. And so for all mothers and mother figures, we thank you for all that you've done for us over the years. And we ask the Almighty God's blessing to be upon the mothers and mother figures who are here today. Please watch over them, protect them, and may they know always our gratitude for all the sacrifices they have made, particularly when they model what they do after the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, so gentlemen, you can stand now. At the very, very least, you can't say you need to get your exercise today. Stand up, sit down, kneel. Stand up, sit down, kneel. Anyway, the Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God have you know and humbly pray. And to the help of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cross into hell safely, and all of these spirits, the proud of the world, seek in turn of souls. Amen. The Smiths were shown into the dentist's office, where Mr. Smith made it clear he was in a big hurry. No expensive extras, doctor, he ordered. No gas or needles or any of that fancy stuff. Just pull the tooth and get it over with. I wish more of my patients were as stoic as you, said the dentist admiringly. Now, which tooth is it? Mr. Smith turned to his wife. Show him your tooth, honey.
Down. Yeah.
Good night, Jane.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, that's a wrap. Thank you. Join us next week.